What's up, everybody? For the Itachi here, you know what it is. It is bright, but it is not. It is just a big, bright kitchen light on me right now because it is super dark outside. It is just about to hit 9 o'clock. The movie starts at 10:55. We are going to be watching, finally, after so many years of playing World of Warcraft, after playing Warcraft, StarCraft has nothing to do with it, but it's still a Blizzard game. Overwatch, Heroes of the Storm, Hearthstone, you name it, Blizzard Entertainment Games, we are finally getting a movie, and it is going to be Warcraft. It is not the Warcraft we expect from the World of Warcraft, it is the Warcraft to expect from the original, the Orcs vs. Humans Warcraft, the OG where Gul'dan is the bad man himself. Where the orcs, the brown orcs, I should say, are looking for help from the humans. And the humans and the orcs gotta work together to basically push back the green orcs. And I've heard so much about the movie. I've seen every single preview. I've seen everything at youtube.com/legendarypictures. I've seen everything, all the hype for this video. And it did very well everywhere else in the world. Not sure why America is to get this last. The movie comes out June 10th, but it is June 9th right now. I am still sick, but I should be fine because I feel much better. It's just congestion up here. But we are going to be doing a review on this video, and I hope you enjoy this video. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. We're going to do a mini vlog before we get there and a mini vlog after. And yeah, this is something new for the channel. But we are going to be getting to the movie theaters pretty soon. I am going to get ready. So let's go ahead and show you what the hell I've got in store. As all of you know, prices at movie theaters suck complete balls. So let's get some high chews. Stack them out, stack them in, let the stacks begin. That should be enough. And what other candies do we got in here? Ooh, we got some lollipops. Let's get two of these. These last a while too. Get different flavors though. Oh, nice. Alright, so we've got some assorted fruit lollipops. We've got some high chews. I do not need to bring no chips. I don't really like to eat that much. Just in case, we've got all of this. So, what do you need when you go to a movie theaters? You need pockets. Unless you were a female, you've got it in the bag. Ha! Get it? You've got it in the bag. Alright, you know what? We don't need this much. Let's go ahead and take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, just one of these, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. 10 is enough. And we stack them in the pocket, flatten it out, make it look like there's nothing. And you know what's even better about this pocket? The zipper doesn't really work because it doesn't have this end piece. It's all messed up, so it just has the thing that goes up and down. Let's go ahead and put these ones back. We're getting ready for the movies, guys, and I'm not paying no ridiculous price for popcorn. I don't really need a drink. I mean, if I was a female, or if it was cold outside, I'd have a jacket and I can fill one of those Gatorades or Sobeys with me. But I really don't need a drink, so we are good. Gonna grab the keys, headband, the bracelets, the wallet, and we're gonna be heading off to the movie theaters. Alright, what's up, everybody? I have just gotten ready, heading downstairs. I know the camera's on weird angle right now. Heading downstairs, it is dark outside, of course, because it is nighttime. It is the preview night, or the pre-night for the Warcraft movie. Again, Warcraft comes out tomorrow, but there's always movie theaters that love to break the rules and show them a day early. It's just a common sense thing. It's always, never shows, like if something's on August 31st, it's going to come out August 30th. It might not even be on August 31st, who knows? Like February 45th, it's going to come out February 44th. I'm joking now because I don't even know if there's an August 31st. Might just end on a 30th, but pretty sure there's a 31st in August. But let's go ahead and make our way out. Hopefully the camera still shows and I am black as right now. Look at that. Can't even see me anymore. So we got the whip. The whip is ready. As you can see, it is super shiny. I just cleaned it after I cleaned it right before I went to work. Whip is ready. About to go in, about to go. Arrived into the parking garage. We are about an hour away from watching the movie. Gonna go ahead and say goodbye to the whip. Peace out, whip. I'm gonna go ahead and walk around in the mall for about a good hour and then we'll be heading over to the movie. So I'll see you guys in a little bit. Back at it again. We just got the tickets. Got my tickets, and we got a free Warcraft game. I'll give it away on my YouTube channel if I can. I'll read more into it. I'll read it right now, actually. It comes with a Warcraft exclusive free World of Warcraft, the game, redeem at warcraft.com/movie. Plus 4 movie-inspired Transmog skins. We've already got that in the game. When the movie ends, the battle continues. So basically... Oh, so we got a code. So yeah, I'll be giving away a World of Warcraft game on my YouTube channel. I went over to the mall. Pretty much, I just picked up the tickets. Got the tickets right here. Yeah, it's dark here right now, but chillax. It's all Gucci. We're gonna go ahead and head over to the mall. We're gonna shop for a little bit. We're probably not gonna get anything unless GameStop's open. We'll go ahead and grab some goddamn Pokemon cards, because that's just how I roll. Let's get into the light sun. And then we'll go ahead and head over back to the movie theaters when it is closer to the time frame of getting the movie watched. Cannot wait. Got a free game to give away, so I'll read more into it. But I'm pretty sure it's a free World of Warcraft game. The MMORPG, which you guys know that I play all day, every day. Hopefully I'm back at it again soon. Legion is coming out. Doubt this comes with Legion, but it's probably going to come up with everything until Warlords of Draenor, so you got all of that ready to go. And until then, I will go ahead and see you on the other side, right before the movie begins. First one in the movie theater like a boss. Oh, you can't see me. Can't see me. Oh, snap. Oh, snap. Oh, snap. Alright, this is how you do it. It's empty in here. You do it, though. Empty. Empty. No one in here. Alright, there's people starting to come. People starting to come. Let's turn off the camera. Everybody, for the one Itachi here. The movie has just finished, and I am looking forward to giving you guys a full review on the movie itself, my thoughts. In this next part of the video, there is going to be some spoilers. So I do want to say, if you do not want to be spoiled about the movie, do not watch the rest of this video. But for now, I'm going to go ahead and head home, and I know it's very dark right now. I'm going to go ahead and head home, and then I'm going to go ahead and give you guys the review tomorrow after I've woken up. It is now 2 o'clock in the morning, but yeah, I will be giving you guys the review tomorrow, and then I will go ahead and release the video tomorrow as well, so stay tuned. What's up, everybody? For the win, Itachi here, and welcome to the review portion of the Warcraft film. Again, this part of the video is going to have spoilers, so a little quick spoiler alert before you adventure into the rest of this video. I just want to say, if you do not want to be spoiled, go ahead and pause the video. It is okay. It is okay. So go ahead and pause the video, but if you are ready for the review, here we go. We're going to be starting off with the characters and the cast and crew themselves. We're not going to be going into deep detail on everybody. There was officers, there was lieutenants, there was a sheep, there was, goddamn, what else can I remember? There was some prison people, there's so much. Oh, Elodie, which was the lady from the Kirin Tor. For Khadgar, and there was also Draka, who's the Orkin that gave birth to, from Durotan's child, I believe. But we're not going to be going into deep details on that, but there is a big list of characters that I do want to talk about, and they were the main characters that you actually get to see a lot of content from. And this is in no particular order in the order of what I think was the best, but the final three will be my favorite. We're gonna go ahead and talk about Lady Taria, who is the queen, played by Ruth Negga. This is the queen of Stormwind, who was with Lane Rin, played by Dominic Cooper. Lane Rin, as well as Lady Taria, I'm going to put them together because they were pretty much together, king and queen of Stormwind for the Alliance, human racials, you know what it is. He did not use his human racial too much. I mean, he didn't use it, but jokes aside, they were played fantastic. Lady Taria she looked like a queen. The way she presented herself in this film, the way she spoke, it was top-notch, and I truly enjoyed it. Lane Rin, however, he was a little bit different. Still sick, by the way.
Lane Rin was a little bit different. He resembled the king because he does look like Lane Rin from the game itself. But the fact of the matter, he was kind of short in my opinion, but played a great role in the film, and acting unbelievable. Cannot say anything about that. I do want to go with Blackhand next. One of the bad guys on Orcs, played by Clancy Brown. Blackhand, I feel bad for. He was basically Gul'dan's left-hand man. He was Gul'dan's lieutenant throughout the whole film. And he was used. He sort of sided with Orgrim as well as Durotan, but he was forced to be used by Gul'dan, and Gul'dan inflicted him with his fell energy, and Blackhand, poor Blackhand, just was forced to be Gul'dan's basically left-hand man, and he couldn't deal anything with it. Felt very bad. He did put himself in the situation. He was played very well by Clancy Brown. And yeah, next up, Orgrim, Durotan's left-hand man. Orgrim was absolutely amazing. The scene where Orgrim and Durotan, where Orgrim was releasing Durotan from his prison for the Frost Wolves, it was absolutely. It was funny because they were fighting back and forth because they're basically like brothers. They're super close, and I really enjoyed that. Medivh, the played by Ben Foster. Now Medivh, he was a guardian for the humans. It was a mage, of course. Medivh was a bad guy and a good guy at the same time in this film. He was a guardian that ended up saving the day. But he was also inflicted by Fel, and everything from start to finish with Medivh was absolutely great, and I truly loved how Ben Foster played it because he looked absolutely perfect for the part. I believe we've got Durotan next. Yeah, we'll go with Durotan next. Durotan was played by, I believe, Toby Kebbell, if I am not mistaken. Durotan was the complete bee's knees for the orcs. He was. If there was no Gul'dan, he'd be my number one orc because I really truly enjoyed it. My favorite scene of the whole movie was watching Durotan fight Gul'dan. I just felt Durotan wanting to help the orcs and free the orcs from Gul'dan, but he couldn't do too much because Gul'dan is just self-inflicted and he is absolutely. It's Gul'dan. What can you do? He is the bad guy. He has all the power in his hands. He controls everybody because everybody has fell, so he can kill anybody at in the snap of his fingers. And poor Durotan was kind of struggling. Did lose the fight against Gul'dan, but that fight was absolutely my favorite scene to watch because Durotan was an absolute boss in this whole film. And I'm glad he tried to side with the humans. It was his intellect that I should say. Durotan's intellectual being was absolutely top-notch compared to most orcs, and now I can see why he was chieftain. Next up, I want to go with Khadgar, and then we'll go with my final three. Khadgar was another main character in the film. He was a mage. Khadgar was an absolute pro. He brought the comedy to the film, in my opinion. We in World of Warcraft and Warlords of Draenor, the latest expansion, we see Khadgar how he is now, but back in the day when the actual Warcraft film is being placed in that time zone, Khadgar was a little young person. I'm just gonna say that young person, and he just brought the comedy to the film, and it was absolutely amazing. Played by Ben Schnetzer. But now my final three. These are now in order from my top three. At number three, we have Anduin Lothar, main character of the film, played by Travis Fimmel, if I'm not mistaken. Fimmel, basically Anduin Lothar later becomes the king of Stormwind, basically takes over for his father who got killed in the war, Lane Rin. But Anduin was an absolute boss in the film. He was the main character for the humans. So I have to side with him as number three. Number two, I'm gonna go with Gul'dan, played by Daniel Wu. I know this one by heart because Gul'dan's a warlock. As you guys know, I play a warlock in the game. Gul'dan's an absolute boss. I don't really like him from what I've seen, but he looked amazing. Aesthetically, he was amazing. The architecture, everything that went into his body. I don't know how they turned a human into Gul'dan. It was absolutely amazing to watch. And the way he spoke, the way he took control, he's just a bad guy. You got to put him up in your top three, no matter if you hated him or not. I did. Before the film, I didn't hate him. I thought he was the bee's knees of all bee's knees. I thought he was a pro of all pros because he's a warlock. But now I don't really like him too much. But I can't hate him because he's Gul'dan. He's a warlock. Favorite character of the film, by far, was Garona, played by Paula Patton. Garona looked absolutely amazing. Garona is a half-orc, half-Drenai, and Garona was the main character besides Lothar for the film. Garona and Lothar had a love scene. At the end of the film, Garona has to backstab the humans, but it was in a way where she wasn't backstabbing humans. It was so she can get side with the orcs again, because not to side with the orcs again, she was already with the orcs, but it was for her to rise to power, sort of speak, and for her to dig her claws into gaining power with Gul'dan, to take control of the orcs, to gain a little bit of power with the orcs, to gain a little say with the orcs, and for her to now let the orcs know Gul'dan's a bad guy. We need to side with the humans. We need to become our own beings. We need to live with peace with the humans, and that's what Garona's going to try to do. But sadly, Garona is kind of basically mind-controlled by Gul'dan, but not necessarily, and Paula Patton played it, the role, absolutely amazing. The scene where she kills Lane Wren was, I did not see that coming. I absolutely did not know about that in the lore, but for her to do that and for Lane Wren to think of that in that type of situation was absolutely amazing. The film was absolutely amazing. All the characters that I just talked about were absolutely great. It was fun to watch from start to finish. From the film perspective, all the buildings, all of the characters, everything looked perfect. From the armor, from the weapons, to the mages casting spells. My favorite character, even above Garona, was the Frost Wolves themselves. They were so massive. The Griffins looked great as well. But the Frost Wolves, man, for the Horde. The Frost Wolves were absolutely amazing. I would love to have one of those IRL, but sadly we can't because they're too freaking huge. The Orcs are big, so imagine a Frost Wolf. It's not even going to fit in this room. But everything that went into this film was great. I do agree with the fact that the film could have been longer, but I understand why they did not make it longer. And in fact, it's two worlds and one home for Warcraft. It is now playing in cinema. It is a 2-hour-long movie that is including credits. There is going to be a director's cut when it comes out on DVD. I am hoping. They have stated it. I am hoping it does go through. Can't wait to get it on DVD, and I'll give you guys another review then. You can see this in real D, 3D, and well as IMAX and regular on theaters. I saw this on regular, so I do not have any IMAX or real D, 3D perspective on this. I just saw regular because I've already seen movies in IMAX and real D, 3D. There's not much of a difference. You just put on glasses and it's the same thing. It's like looking into a 3DS. It's not really 3D, in my opinion. So I watched it on regular. But out of a 10, I would give this a 9. The reason being, I really love the franchise of Warcraft. The film was actually what I thought it would be, and I am very happy to see it. Now, guess what? I'm going to leave you with one more thing. First of all, I just want to say thank you very much for tuning in. Check out the description box. Thumbs up. Comment down below if you have any questions or if you have any comments. Last thing I'm going to leave you guys with. I believe there's going to be another Warcraft film very soon, and I cannot wait. I hope that someone from the Warcraft franchise sees this video that I'm making. Cast me into this next film, please. I would love to be a part of it. I'm a true fan, as you guys know. I truly loved what you guys did, and being able to be a part of that would be a great experience. And I just want to say, for those of you that tuned in, thank you very much for tuning in. For the Itachi is out.